So it is the 1st of July, and that means tomorrow is the Sapphicathon, which is a 24-hour readathon. The only prompt is read a Sapphic book or more. And I know I just came off of failing a 48-hour readathon, but I'm going to take part. I'm going to take part with this. And this is mainly because this is a novella. It is 198 pages, and the text isn't big, but it isn't small either, so it, you know, there is a chance that I'm actually going to succeed this time. It is more in my kind of genre wheelhouse. I've been really looking forward to this one. And recently there was a video posted compared to the book by one of the authors, which was the Painted Skin Dance, and I love that, so I had to. That bumped it right up the priority list. And also because I do like vlogs and I don't like editing, and 24 hours means I can probably do a vlog and not have to edit too much. So all in all, it seemed like a really good idea. Famous last words. But it seemed like a really good idea, so this is what we're doing. Also, while we're here, I may also want to just show off my strawberries because I'm very proud of them. So it's past 5, and I have been awake for far, far too long. But there was a Q&A on Saint on S.D. Gibson's Instagram about querying and submissions, and I watched that, and I got distracted with Nano. And now here we are, full of regret. But also, I started. I'm very early on, but first impressions are this is like Catra from She-Ra, except if she was both of them, and I absolutely adore that comparison. So, this is amazing. Hey, it's like 6 o'clock. I have just recently woken up, and I am so tired. I feel a little sick, but it's almost dinner time, so we're going to spend this half hour reading. I am on page 66 currently, so not bad. And yeah, I probably do stand a good chance of getting this finished tonight. And if I do, which is a big if, both in terms of like finishing it and having the will to go on, I will continue reading The Henna Wars, which I started last month. So we've just gone past 8 o'clock and I am on page 109. So that's about 90 pages left to go. I have a lot of confidence that I can finish it. But I'm lagging right now. I'm usually fine setting up, but I think I need to lie down soon. I don't really wanna film in bed. So I thought I would talk a little bit about the books that came in to try and, you know, pick myself back up. This is A Devil with Blood by S.D. Gibson. I actually got an e-arc of this, and then the exhaustion was just terrible this year and I haven't really managed to review it. I will get to that eventually. This is an absolutely gorgeous, stunning piece of work. It follows this polyamorous relationship between Dracula's brides over the ages and the relationship tune with him, which isn't great. It is lyrical and beautiful and they're amazing. Also, I think there is a short story kind of epilogue coming out soon. If you follow her like newsletters, and like, I'm so excited. I highly recommend the book and also following her to see that. And then this one just came out, I think, at the end of last month. It is The Bone Way by Holly J. Underhill. This is a sapphic retelling of the myth of Orpheus and Eurydice, which you might be able to tell I really love. I don't really know much more about that, and I don't really want to read the back cover. I don't remember the synopsis and I kind of want to keep it that way, just experience it as it goes. But yes, I'm very excited for this. This is the third book this company has published and I have all of them now. I have their Unspeakable Anthology somewhere. It's also great, and I highly recommend that too. Well, that was amazing and it made me cry. Some books you can talk about and some books you just kind of have to sit with, so I don't really have anything to say at the moment, just that I absolutely loved it. Hey, so it's now 10:30 and I have started Dowry. I know I said I would probably keep going with the Hen of Wars and this is my first read of that, but I finished This Is How We Lose the Time War and immediately wanted to jump to this, so that's what I did. I didn't mention last time, it didn't really occur to me to mention that one of the brides, the last bride, is Alexei, is a man. But yeah, we still have Constanza and Magdalena, whom I adore, so it is still sapphic. But yeah, this is what we're doing now. There are less than 10 minutes in the day and I have called it quits 10 pages into A Devil of Blood because I realised what it was that made me drawn to this after reading This Is How We Lose the Time War, which was very emotional, and this is also a very emotional, beautiful read. A lot more aching than... I still stand by what I said about Catra at the beginning of This Is How We Lose the Time War. A Devilry of Blood is not quite so high octane in terms of emotionality, but that is the through line that drew me to it. If you're wondering where their words have gone, it is into my quote book. coat journal. It is a mess, it's ugly, I know, but I love it. Yeah. So Delroy also has a lot of amazing quotes. And I would like to get a few more words in for Nano before the day is out. But I don't think I did too bad today, so I'm happy.